Hi Tribe, welcome back to another educational cannabis adventure on High Quality Crystal. I'm Crystal, and if you're new here, maybe consider subscribing if you dig what you see.
I like that one. I thought you were just gonna mess up on your tummy.
What I have with me today is CBD hemp flower from Industrial Hemp Farms. I guess they're the largest supplier of hemp in the country? They do have Delta 8 products, which are in the mail on their way to me right now, so keep an eye out for those videos. But today we're gonna focus on the second most popular cannabinoid, CBD. You may know of CBD flower already because of strains like Cannatonic or Harley Quinn. These are high CBD flowers with THC. These types of CBD heavy flower are only available for purchase in legal states from licensed dispensaries. What I have here is not CBD flower.
It smells really good.
This is hemp flower. This contains the legal percentage of D9THC, which is 0.3%, and you can buy it online in nearly every state. Now here's some knowledge. CBD is derived from the cannabis sativa plant, and loads of people say that it's beneficial for pain, inflammation, sleep, relaxation, but with none of the intoxicating effects of marijuana. People say they use CBD for depression, anxiety, insomnia, but there's no studies confirming these benefits of CBD. For now, the only FDA-approved method to administer CBD is for the treatment of rare severe epilepsy in children. There is, however, more and more evidence all the time to support the use of CBD for a bunch of conditions, like treating challenging chronic pain or an opioid addiction. You can take CBD orally, like with gummies, or topically with a compound, or you can smoke it, which seems to be the most effective way to get CBD into your system. So even though there's no evidence proving that CBD helps with depression, anxiety, insomnia, there are studies that prove the most efficient way to get CBD into you is via smoking. I don't hate it.
Kind of nice.
CBD does interact with some prescription medications, so if you're thinking about self-medicating with CBD, really seriously talk to your doctor about it first, okay? Something else that I have seen people use CBD for that actually works is using it to bring you down from a high that's way too intense. CBD has been demonstrated to moderate a high by preventing the body's ability to absorb the THC. CBD actually interferes with the CB1 receptor, especially in the presence of THC. So that's why when THC and CBD work together, people do report having a more mellow high, and there's less likely of a chance that paranoia is gonna come into play when you have THC and CBD working together at the same time. That is known as the entourage effect, which is why different combinations of cannabinoids and terpenes seem to enhance the benefits of cannabis for some people. Science. Be careful using CBD products because there isn't a whole lot of regulation and there have been companies found with incorrect labeling. So how do you know whether you're getting the good stuff, the stuff that's properly made and properly labeled? I will link the science article in the description in case you guys want to read the whole thing. It was like a clinician's guide to cannabinoid and hemp oil. I've said it before, and I'm going to say it again, whatever you get, make sure that it has a COA, a certificate of analysis. That means that it's been tested, not only its levels of THC, D8, D9, CBN, it's also getting tested for harsh metals, pesticides, solvent residue. If I don't see a COA, I don't take the product. Also look to make sure that they are meeting the FDA's quality standard, and they should have some sort of certification for that as well, which basically says that their manufacturing processes, their factories are safe. And this isn't just a guide for CBD, this is for any cannabis product that you have. Industrial Hemp Farms, this CBD flower, is banana kush flavor, super tasty. I was surprised at how good it tasted. It has like a weird flavor to it, but it's not a bad flavor, it's just different. The effects were, as I expected, calming, relaxing, a little bit sleepy, and I needed it the day that I smoked this. I had a rough couple days.
I feel like the world is upside down.
And I was like, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna smoke some CBD because I feel like I'm losing my mind, I'm coming out of my skin. It did wind up helping me. It gave me the kickstart of unwinding from such a stressful and chaotic couple days. After which, I ate 15 milligrams of Delta 9 THC and had a really good night of giggling and watching Mortal Kombat. Thank you to Industrial Hemp Farms for sending out this flower to me, and I'm looking forward to receiving some of those Delta 8 products that I have on the way. Thank you guys for being here on another one of my cannabis adventures. I know CBD is like probably not what people go for. They want the stoner stuff. So thank you for being here with me because it makes me feel like I'm not so alone and I'm not the only one that has a low tolerance on this planet. I hope you learned something that comes in handy in your life. Be safe, make good choices, have a stellar day, and I'll see you guys next week. Happy high partakers.